Dear friends, as you already know, we have been breeding different Uromastyx species for many years now. To summarize our long-term experience, we prepared a short video called 10 Facts about breeding of Uromastyx species. These facts are not all new and probably most of you already know some of them, but we think that gathering these facts together in one set will help new breeders or people who have Uromastyx for the first time to organize their breeding projects. Fact number one. The most important key to successful breeding is good parental stock and favorable keeping conditions. Appropriate diet, temperature and lighting regime, exposure to ultraviolet and adequate interior decoration will make the animal strong enough to undergo winter dormancy and give you a healthy clutch and therefore healthy numerous offsprings. Fact number two. Proper winter dormancy is necessary to stimulate breeding behavior. It consists of a complex of actions, decreasing of lighting period, feeding, temperature and reverse process. Regular control of animals' health and physical appearance is of top importance. Fact number three. Bright coloration and mating behavior, intensive head bobbing, are good signs that males are ready to breed. A female can mate with a male many times. For red-banded mastigers, Uromastyx disparflaviafasciata, we observed 8 copulations with one female this year. Fact number 4. Not all eggs from every female will be fertile even in case of observed mating. To increase the chance of getting fertile eggs, a female can be placed with different males daily or every other day during breeding season. These time gaps are important for her to have a rest. Fact number 5. There are some females that perfectly imitate males' behavior. Probably this is an anomaly. Such females can be colored like males, demonstrate head bobbing, and even imitate copulation with true females. Fact number 6. Females will not always lay eggs where you expect them to do it. It is extremely important to check all possible places where she can dig and make a nest. So, it is necessary to keep an eye on a gravid female when she starts to dig. Digging can last for several days and mom can change the desirable place for egg laying several times. As soon as females become thin, it is strict indication to carefully search for eggs. Fact number 7. Fertile eggs will always have a red area that is visible if the egg is placed on a torch. When placing them inside the incubation box, make sure that the red area is on the upper side of the egg. If you change the egg's polarity, even a fertile egg will die in several days. Fact number 8. After oviposition, female is heavily dehydrated. Proper meal and some water is what she needs this time. It is better to separate a female from a male, as in some rare cases, males can try to mate again and put female to unnecessary stress or even kill her in attempts to copulate again. Those females who are not ready to breed for some reasons or already gravid will try to lay upside down in order to not allow a male any access to her cloaca. Fact number 9. Free exchange of animals from different bloodlines among breeders all over the world is top important to maintain strong and healthy populations in captivity. Possibility to transfer animals between collections will help to maintain gene heterogeneity of breeding stocks in different groups and therefore reduce stress on wild populations. Fact number 10. The possibility of getting legal wild-caught founder stock is vital to reduce risks of inbreeding depression. Acting of responsible herpetoculturists to increase the gene pools of Uromastyx and determine the conditions for multi-generation breeding is the only way of development of spiny-tailed lizards in herpetoculture. Well, my friends, you are very welcome to share your experience in keeping and breeding of different Uromastyx species in our Facebook group called Responsible Herpetoculture. Any information is valuable, whether it is keeping conditions or different breeding approaches. We hope that this information will be valuable for everybody and it will help us to build responsible herpetoculture. Goodbye.